It's official. You're listening to the I'm Wired to Inspire podcast, creatively engineered by me, your host, your girl, Robin Nicole, the inspiration specialist. I'm Wired to Inspire is a powerfully packed podcast filled with inspiration and encouragement to get you through your day. It's designed to inspire you to live your authentic purpose. Now stay tuned for today's episode of the I'm Wired to Inspire podcast. Hey everyone, and thank you so much for joining me today on my podcast. It's your girl, Robin Nicole, the inspiration specialist, and I'm wired to inspire you to live your authentic purpose. So guys, thank you so much for joining me today. It's the top of the week. I'm praying that you guys have an awesome time, y'all. We are still in quarantine. We're still taking this thing day by day, but I'm so excited for the things that God is doing. And for those of you who have tuned in and you decided to spend some time with me, I don't take that for granted, and I appreciate all that you've done for me and in support. And with that being said, I wanted to share something with you guys that I think will help you. I know some things that I'm personally going through that's not common knowledge, but, you know, I was sitting around and I said, you know, Lord, maybe I'm not the only person having this experience, and maybe I need to, they might not be going through some of the things I'm going through, but maybe the advice for healing or the advice for change might be something that we all can use, right? So let me give you an example of what I mean. Today's episode is called, What Do You Consider? And I did that because if you're not aware, I'm a songwriter and I dropped my first album last week. And that was something that it was hard for me to do. That was not an easy thing for me to do. I think sometimes people assume when they see you out doing a bunch of different stuff that things are just super easy for you. I had to grow into a lot of the things that I do now, and I really did it by the grace of God. So one of the things, y'all, I tell you, is like I started to pay attention to certain things. And it's not that I'm oblivious, but I think sometimes, y'all, the first thing I want you to know is that you have to pick your battles. You know, you learn so much about yourself and people when God calls you into your purpose. And when your purpose is unique and other people cannot take credit for the things that you get that garner you success, and God is the only one that can take that credit, those people either don't want to be bothered or they don't want to acknowledge what you have going on. For some people, they just don't even know. Other people, they're jealous. Other people, it's not that they're trying to be jealous, but they're not doing nothing for themselves. And some people just flat out don't like you or don't like what you're doing. I think each and every one of those things I just said, they all mean something to somebody when they happen. Now, how we choose to react to those things, that's on us. Okay? So I was thinking about everything, and I remembered a song a while ago that I heard. And I'm like, man, this thing is so awesome. But when it dropped, apparently it had been out, she had written it years ago. You know what I'm saying? She wrote it a long time ago. And when she dropped it was time. And I know that there are people who, quote unquote, support me or whatever. And I don't mean to say that with an attitude or cockiness, but I say quote unquote because I know that a lot of it has to do with it sounds too old or it's not. I don't care what it sounds like. And I think that's the thing that makes people angry, because it's not that I'm naive and I don't understand that there's a practicality and there are rules to putting certain things out. But when I'm told to do something by the Holy Spirit, I do it. I don't care what man tell me. And even if it don't fit their standard, they don't have to be a part of it, because this is what I've seen in my life personally as long as I've been living. When God wants to pull the trigger for you, he gonna pull the trigger. And I don't care what's in store and what you have to do. If you do what he tells you to do, when he wanna pull the trigger, he's gonna pull the trigger. Just that simple. No man, no person, no situation, no opportunity. Nothing is going to forfeit that. Nothing is going to make you forfeit that. It's not going to happen. Because if you're inside of the will of God, he is going to make sure that you get all your gots. You're going to get everything you're supposed to get. And so I was realizing that, man, you know, this is so interesting, because so many people have their opinion of what they think, you know, should be. And something I was telling a mentee recently, I'm like, listen, if you are concerned about what people have to say and what people think about something that God tells you to put out in purpose, then you got this whole thing off, because you're not getting the point of why God is using you. when God handpicks us and selects us to do something, especially when you do it in a secular world or you do it with a group of people or a situation that's not the normal standard, you are going to be attacked. People are going to drag you for filth. Number one, because they can't control you. Number two, because it's not what they like. And I think sometimes people don't understand that just because you don't like something that a person does or you're not a fan of it, it does not mean that you cannot support their effort. Moreover, it does not mean that you beefing with them. It just means that one person might like A and another person might like B. But at the end of the day, you have to do what God is telling you to do. One of the things that you will find when you are consistently doing what the Father tells you to do, you will be happy. You will not be caught up in what other people are telling you. You will not get stuck in a mode of, well, I got to do this, I got to do that. Y'all, I almost had a situation where somebody was trying to literally make me go back in time and repeat everything I did in my past when I had already paid those dues. Because the thing that I didn't realize was God already marked me for wealth. God already marked me for success. He'd already marked me to do these things because I was doing it through him. The reason why I couldn't be successful before was because I had to do it my way. I didn't do it his way. So when I finally acquiesced and said, hey, God, I'm going to do this the way you're telling me to do it, everything began to change. But some of those same people had to go because they don't want to be affiliated with it. You know, and the thing about it is, y'all, it's not spiritual. This is not super Jesus-y. This is very plain and simple. Either you're going to do it the way God tell you to do it or you're not. When you do it the way he tells you, you're going to be surprised by a lot of people and a lot of things. If you're not okay with that, then you might need to revisit your commitment to doing what God is calling you to do, because there's going to be plenty of that. That's just par for the course. It's what happens. And you got to decide, let me pick my battles. You're going to have to start paying attention to what kind of effort and energy and what you do for other people versus what they do for you. You're going to have to reset and refocus and say, hey, God, listen, I want to do this thing the way you're telling me to do it, but X, Y, and Z is happening. Because here's the thing, y'all. I found myself seeing other people get upset because they felt people's reactions to certain things I did, they didn't like their reactions. But y'all, like, I had to tell them, and I'm telling this to somebody who's listening to me right now, like, I had to get them together. It was things being said about me, but I wasn't even offended. I mean, I wasn't even offended, but other people who care about me were offended. But this is why I wasn't offended. I was not favored. Let me say that. I was not favored because I did something that God told me to do. When I've done things before and I wasn't favored, it was because I did it my way and I got what I was supposed to get. But when you do things that God tells you to do and it seemingly looks like you're going backwards or it's not acceptable or it blows up in your face, I will never be mad at nobody feeling no kind of way about me when I do that, because number one, God is showing people how people really feel about me. And number two, it also shows me that I was willing to take the risk and step out on faith, knowing that if I did it God's way, it wasn't going to be the most popular way. Why? Because nothing God does ever is. It's only popular when you win it. Because let me tell you what he does for believers and people who really put him first. We always end up winning. And people going to hate you. They're going to say whatever they want to say. But y'all, the whole point of this thing is, what do you consider? Because for me, I'm considering those who consider me. I say all that to say that one thing. Y'all, you determine what you consider by what considers you. The Bible said he first loved us. He first loved us. It wasn't the other way around. Y'all, we have a choice, okay? We have a choice. I literally had no desire to talk about this, but people who care about me were so upset. That, first of all, that's a whole other podcast about having people that really hold you down no matter what you go through. Just that part right there had me in a beautiful space and in a beautiful emotional space, praising and thanking God for having people who really care about me like that. But I really wanted to make this for those of you who support other people who have things going on, and for those of you who are in a position where God is telling you to start the business, but somebody is going to say, you don't have no money, you don't have no business savvy. This is for the person who, you know, they've been wanting to put their songs out and they want to sing in front of the world, but they're like, oh, well, they don't like my tone. If you know you really have that gift and you're not, you know, and I'm it's going to sound silly, but you know you're not tone deaf, because some people really can't sing. Oh, God, forgive me. Y'all know I'm silly. Listen, you know I'm silly. I'm not perfect. Don't hold it against me. But when you know you really have a gift, y'all, just know whatever your gift is, it's not made for everybody. Everybody is not going to like what you do. So this message today is for you. What do you consider? And whom do you consider? You know, I just wanted to let people know, like, those of you who support me personally, I really appreciate. And those of you who don't, that's fine too. I mean, everybody's not going to do it. But I also think that you need to be prayerful and wise about who you call, how you call people in your life and what they do and what they see and what they let pass by versus what you do for them. Because that is a huge wake-up call for me in this season too. Being very transparent about that. So please, y'all, do not play yourself worrying so much about what somebody says, because if you're so caught up in what somebody's saying and doing or not doing right now, when God is telling you to do it for purpose, then you're missing the point of what God is telling you to do. Do not waste your energy on that. If God gave you a directive, it is for a godly reason. You do not need to be sitting around waiting on nobody else to tell you it's okay to do it. And if they don't like it, to God be the glory. God is showing you something. If they do like it, to God be the glory. God is showing you something. But if you have the attitude that everybody's supposed to like what you do, everybody is supposed to support you, everybody's supposed to do this, and you listen, if that's where your mind is, I hate to tell you, but you're missing it. You're not getting it. Your whole purpose is to do it when, why, and how God tells you to do it. That is your main purpose. All of the other stuff, like we say in the NO, the French word is land yap, is extra. Anything else is extra. You get down to the bare bones and you do what God is telling you to do. You're going to learn some things. You might be a little hurt. You might have to shake the dust off your feet. You might have to let it roll off you like a duck's back. Whatever you got to do. But y'all, moving forward, let's focus on our purpose. And remember, what do you consider? When you ask yourself that question, everything is going to start making sense. But in this season of releasing projects and starting new jobs and businesses and careers and relationships, they're going to have a bunch of people that's going to hate because they stuff didn't work out. It's a bunch of people that's going to think, man, how she got with him? Oh, dang, how he got with her? Ooh. It's going to be so much of that going on. But that should not stop you. That should not be the barometer set for you to decide how you're going to move in your situation. Y'all, if I worried about what people thought, I wouldn't do a podcast, books, clothing, music, and nothing else I feel inspired to do. I would do none of it because I would be crying behind people who smile in my face and stab me in my back. I'd be crying behind people who drag me for filth because they don't like it. That's their prerogative. That's not my business. But if you don't find joy and peace and moving forward regardless, you are not going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, because y'all, the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living is in that space. Freedom. True freedom is when you're not caught up when not near person say about you. True freedom is when you commit to Christ and say, hey, this is what I'm going to do. You say, this is my purpose and calling. This is how you want me to do it. I'm not worrying about this executive. I'm not worrying about this platform. I'm not worrying about these people. I'm not worrying about that connection. When you say, hey, you my divine connection, I'm not trying to make myself go viral. I'm not trying to connect with this one. I'm not telling this one that one. When you get to that space, nothing. Do you hear me? Nothing but good things are going to come to you. It doesn't mean that the bad things are not going to try to form against you, but they're going to form and that's it. They're going to fall to the ground. So be encouraged. And before you get upset and worried about something that you're trying to do or put out or you're trying to endeavor that God has told you to do, before you get worried and lose sleep about somebody who already could possibly have subpar values already, before you waste any time on them or that, ask yourself, what do I consider? I'm Wired to Inspire. I hope you are too. Thanks for listening to the I'm Wired to Inspire podcast at imwiredtoinspire.com. If you enjoyed the show, spread the word for your girl. Hit the 5-star rating on iTunes. For more information on this podcast and more of my inspirational products and services, log on to imwiredtoinspire.com and remember to live your authentic purpose. Thank y'all so much, and I'll see you next time.